Hello out there and welcome to English Teacher Plays. We're here with The Moon Relax, and it's a new game. It's on Steam, and we're gonna play it. Maybe. It's loading. Oh, my screen just went black. Oh, here we go. The Moon Relax. Version 1.0 to begin. To begin. All right. Yeah, start the game. Let's go. Let's play The Moon Relax.
38 million square kilometers of stone and dust, more than 3,000 kilometers in diameter, which revolves about 384,000 kilometers above our head. The temperature on it varies from minus 173 degrees centigrade at night to plus 127 degrees centigrade at the sunflower point. Its gravity is 6 times less than that of the Earth. A lowly quiet place, however, the moon also possesses a variety of minerals, including metals valuable for industry: iron, aluminum, titanium. Besides, in the surface layer of the lunar soil, the regolith, a rare on-Earth isotope helium-3, has been accumulating, which can be used as a fuel. Many years have passed since the race for space exploration, since the times of the USSR. No one could then have thought it we will mine minerals. The constant dispatch of astronauts to the moon, with a period of 365 Earth days, is a real test of Felton.
The constant dispatch of astronauts to the moon. So it's text-to-speech, which is just always a bad idea. Just voice it yourself, or get someone else to voice it. Text-to-speech is terrible. Oh my god. For the best terrain optimization, please choose which computer you have in terms of performance. Terrain quality and game will depend on the choice. Please note the terrain section is made at the start of the game. When loading, save progress. Pay attention to the cleanness of the frames in the upper right corner of the screen. Sure. Do you want to include post-process? What? Why is everything shaking? No, that's awful.
Go to the moon. Turn on the display of metrics. Press the Q button. Get to the base. Follow the house marker in the dashboard.
Okie dokie. I'm pressing the Q button. How do I... escape. I pressed escape. Alright, so we're on the moon. That's the Earth, I guess. Oh, it's quite pretty. And there's Jupiter, I guess. Sure. Cute. Here we go. So... oh. The moon relax. We are the moon relaxing. Oh, there's like a lunar base here. That's pretty cool. The system kernel has failed. And there's a lot of stuff going on. This is very pretty. Ooh, that's very bright though.
Roll over on the rover. Use the impulse by pressing spacebar. You can see a full description of all keys.
Sure thing. All right. So, we are playing the moon.
Why can't you hear sounds on the open moon? Because the moon has no atmosphere. Sound travels through air, or gases or liquids. There is none of this on the moon. As we already know, sound waves can only move through matter. And since there are practically no such substances in interstellar space and on the moon, sound...
Great. I don't need to hear text-to-speech explaining how the moon works. Inspect...
be sure to close the first two doors of the module behind you to avoid a sudden drop.
Got it. I can improve skills. What is this? Thereby increasing running and walking speed, improve radiation resistance, reduces battery consumption. Right. Sure. Okay, so we did the thing. Alright, we gotta shut the door behind us, though. There we go. The moon relax.
Battery when the energy reserves are at zero, the suit ceases to
All right, so we're here. Where do we recharge the suit battery? Is this where we recharge the suit battery?
As the scale of the food supply decreases, you need to get food. A generator for the production of vegetables will allow you to grow the desired variety and not die.
Sure. You need one carbon granule, one soil pellet, one water granule. Okay, sweet. I don't I don't know what we're up to. So,
press tab button.
Sure. What just happened? Oh, so the game crashed or something? Yeah, the game's fully crashed. Right, I will get back into the game, I guess.
Revolts about 384.
Of course it's unskippable. Of course. I've already listened to this one time. Okay, I'm gonna fast forward. You guys don't need to listen to it twice. Just know that it's not skippable, and the game crashed, and I can't load the other game, so that's what's happening. Okay, so we got past the last part. Great. So we can save it here. Game saved, right. Cool. Right, so how do we get into the next area, I guess, is the question. Alright, do we need to go back outside? I thought this was going to lead to the next area, but I guess not. Let's shut the doors. Alright. And then we'll head back outside. So we don't experience explosive decompression. Yay!
We strongly recommend that you master the skill, instruction 1, in the panel with the U key.
Instruction 1. Except for that I can't. So you gave me a thing, and then I used it, and now you're like, hey, you should do this. Thanks. That's super helpful. I am loving it.
This inner station has 3 buildings. Be sure to go to each module. In the first module there is a chest, a recording, a generator for food, and...
Great. We gotta go to each module. That's fine.
The ore has a special bright color. To get it, use the breaker. When the ore blocks fall apart, collect all the pieces and bring them to the generator. Then you can create any weights.
Sweet. Except for that I can't drive the lunar rover because I didn't take the right skill. If it's such an important skill, maybe start us with that skill. There's almost no reason for us to not start with that skill. It does not make sense for you to tell us to level and then later on tell us that we need to get a specific skill. It's just idiotic. It's fine. Let's go look in the next building. What are these things? There's Mars, I guess. Yep, thank you. So, there is a tutorial, but it is not amazing.
Be sure to close the...
Got it. Right. So, we've got a bunch of granules, which is good. I guess. Sweet, thank you. Right. We got a new level. Cool. Let's do instruction 1. Inventory full. Right. Sure. I guess let's make stuff. We're making a large oxygen cylinder. Cool. And then we go outside and we go to the lunar rover thing and we're gonna go drive it. Alright. Wherever the lunar rover is, we're gonna drive it. Can we walk under this? We can! Yay! Alright. So let's go drive the lunar rover. Alright. There we go. Let's go driving. Oh, it's pretty difficult to see what's going on with this view. Is there... Oh, yeah, we can change the view to that. Or we can change to that. Oh. Cool. So both of these views are terrible. Surprisingly enough, this one is actually the better view. Alright. I don't know what we're looking for. Oh. At least we can spacebar ourselves. Seems safe. This is not the Mako. I've got to remind myself that this is not the Mako. Oh. Why is the view inverted in the car? That is so weird. There's no reason for me to have an inverted view here. So that's why the view is inverted. Okay. So we're just driving around, I guess. I haven't seen anything to interact with yet, but we're doing it. We are exploring the moon. For whatever reason. I mean, it seems pretty featureless. Right? That seems fine, I guess. Oh, there was a mineral. Oh, there's a... Let's go to the exclamation point, I guess. We'll go find out what that is. While we still have battery and oxygen and stuff. At least it's not one of those survival games that, like, immediately takes all of your energy away and stuff, and you're barely, like, holding on. Yeah. One of the screenshots had, like, this weird little girl in it, and I'm like, why is there a little girl? But probably it just turns into some sort of horror game. The system kernel has failed. Okay, well, I don't know what that means. Minor energy leak detected. Also don't know what that means, but that's fine. That all happens. So we're going 1,000... whatever this is being measured in. Towards that exclamation point. Dun 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 dun! Whee! Yeah, it's not quite the Mako. I wish it was the Mako. That would be way cooler. To be honest, that minor energy leak detected. Oop. I guess we're going this way now. Towards Mars! Some floating rocks. Probably want to send home photos of that. Okay, I don't know what's going on here. Whee! There we go. Alright, I'm just gonna keep going this way. Till we get to the exclamation point and we find out what it is. Fatigue. Oh, we're getting tired. And we still haven't even planted any potatoes or anything for eating, so we're probably just gonna die. But that's okay. We don't need to survive. That's not what the survival crafting game is all about. Of course. Engine heats up normally. Man, the driving feels awful, I just gotta say. Yeah. The driving is much worse than you can possibly imagine. Where did the... Oh, there it is. Because some rocks just stop you and then flip you over or whatever, and some of them don't exist. So it's really difficult to navigate. Really, there's no reason for these rocks to be stopping us. It's not adding anything to the game. I get it that they're physics objects and we're trying to drive or whatever, but it's definitely not an addition to the game. It is a subtraction. You know, the poor driving. Just saying. Alright, we're headed to this thing. Now that we know how to operate. Oh, what is that? What did we find? We found a downed spaceship or something. Alright. Cool. Alright. What is this? How do we... Ooh. I don't know what that means. I don't know what we're supposed to be doing here. Right? There's like a spaceship here. It exists, I guess. Yeah, it definitely exists. But there's a building over here. Let's go look in the building. Let's see what the building has to say for itself. Apparently, we're getting quite tired, so... Is there someone here? Why is there an alarm going off? Yeah, it's like a weird alarm going off. I don't know what any of this stuff is. Are we supposed to be picking this up, or... I honestly do not know what I'm meant to be doing, so... Alright, well... I guess we get away from there so we don't have to listen to the alarm going off. Oh, it's my fatigue. Right, we're getting too tired. I guess we need to drive home. I thought the alarm pretty uniquely tied in with us arriving at the thing. So, yeah. Alright. Well, I guess we're headed back. Headed back to the casa. Before we fall asleep. Man, that alarm is really, really annoying. Is there a way to turn that off? It doesn't seem like there is. I pressed escape and it did nothing, so probably I need to get out of the thing and turn it off. So I'll do that once I get back to the house. So far, oh my god. So far I don't know. It's fine. Oh my god. What I thought would be the fun bit, which is the buggy driving, is the least fun thing so far. The most fun thing is, like, looking at space. I always like looking at space. And I'm down for... Oh, of course that happened. I'm down for space being full of rocks and things. That's pretty rad. Alright, do we need to... Oops. Right. Are we gonna stop, or... I don't know. What is that thing? Oh, that's like the crystals that we're supposed to be... Thanks. I have no room in my inventory, so... It literally does not matter what the different ores are. Because I've got to get back to the house, because apparently after about 15 minutes of going around, I am quite tired. And there's a constant alarm in my ears, which is not good. The alarm is bad. The alarm is just trash. Oh my god, it's turning what was like an okay game into like a really unplayable game. Yeah. Great. So what am I supposed to do? Do I click here? Right, okay, well, like I said, oh, this will have made something, right? I can't pick it up, right? Because yeah, I don't have any of that stuff. So it made an oxygen container. That's good. Let's go look at the description because I don't know, man. There is more content or whatever. But I don't like the beer all the time. That's really, really frustrating. I do like what, you know, like I said, I like what space looks like. I like that you can see Mars right there. I like that there's Jupiter there. You know, that's all very cool. This is all cool stuff. But the driving feels not like, it's just not fun. The inventory is very small, and yeah, anyways, let's go look at the description.
The Moon Relax is a realistic exploration and survival game set in a large open world on the moon. Released today, and developed by Indie Games Studio, of course. It costs $7.55. The Moon Relax is a realistic yeah, we already got that. The game is an experiment with unusual mechanics that you have not seen before, with an emphasis on realism. To survive, you have a long way to go. Transport goods, explore the territory, grow vegetables, craft various items, create cargo, mine ores. For example, overdoing it with radiation drugs, the main character can get hallucinations. Also, do not underestimate lunar gravity. It can play into your hands or against you. Great soundtrack, and the atmosphere of the game will help you relax a little. A lot of surprises await you. Are you ready for a challenge in a new, unusual universe? Features: survival on the moon, ability to control the lunar rover, ability to control the drone, craft, explore the skill tree, realistic graphics. The graphics were the nicest thing, for sure. I didn't do any of the mining. The soundtrack was okay. The atmosphere was non-existent, because you're on the moon, right? The force of gravity, I guess. Scoring. I guess there's a score that you can get. Like, it's fine. It did crash once, and then when I tried to exit, it crashed again, and I had to, like, control, delete, and force close Steam so I could get my computer back. So it definitely is not super well optimized. It is a pretty game. I'll give it that. It is a pretty game, but it is, I don't know, man. I didn't feel like there was any need to be doing anything. I know that, like, the crafting stuff was for my own survival. Like, I was supposed to grow some food so that I wouldn't die of starvation. And I'm supposed to create some oxygen so that I can go exploring further. There was a few things. But like I said, the driving the lunar rover was not fun. Yeah, it felt like the driving of it didn't feel very fun, and then often you would get stuck on rocks, which was also not fun. So I know that it was emphasizing realism, but, you know, there is something to be said for fun. I guess this is driving the drone, which seems like it might have been cool, but I didn't end up doing that because I couldn't find the drone. Let's have a look at Indie Games Studio and see what else they've got. Okay, so Indie Games Studio have a few games. Right, what we're gonna do here is we're gonna order this by release dates. Because that usually gives us a pretty good picture of what kind of quality of game they're putting out. So they put out four games in 2018. They put out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 games in 2019. Centralia. There's a lot of these games called Centralia. Did we play Ebola? Nah. I remember seeing it, though. Centralia is actually, it's a town in a lot of places. But I have family that live in Centralia, Illinois. And, yeah, so it's odd there's all these games called Centralia. Centralia Homecoming. I guess that's their thing. 1406 is like 1408, I guess, except for that it's 1406. Doom in the Dark. And we've got The Moon Relax, The Walking Evil. Yeah, so they're like, a lot of these games are trying to cash in on other things' names. Yeah, so that's Indie Games Studio. Looks like they put out four games this year and like 10 last year. So they are prolific developers, but yeah. Yeah, it's... Oh, someone's responding to me on YouTube. That's fun. It's fine. Yeah, it's fine. It's not really fun. It's pretty, but yeah, and my guess is that that's the game. There's not going to be work on it. It's, you know, given their release schedule, my guess is that's as far as the game will go. I'd be interested to know where they got the footage from, or if they... I don't feel like they would have made this footage themselves. I feel like this is purchased or just used. I don't know. But I'm going to leave it there. That's The Moon Relax. I hope you guys enjoy that. If you want to check out the game, you can click on the link in the description. Leave me a comment, like and subscribe, all that kind of stuff. And I will see you guys next time. Class dismissed.